ground. That wow. is a life-giving ocean surface. What an incredible end to Starship's journey. A live view from a buoy that we had out at the landing zone.
An incredible view of a ship landing just about on target as they were calling out.
That was amazing. And we were not intending to recover any of the ship's hardware, so that was the best ending that we could have hoped for.
Some good call-outs there, preparing for re-entry for Starship. And again, that's what Dan was mentioning, those flaps on the vehicle. And if you've been watching us for the last few minutes, you could see that the flaps were rotating around and helping orient the vehicle as it prepares for the beginning of re-entry today.
Yeah, exactly. But when you put 18,000 of them together, they add up to 10.5 tons, which is incredible. Now, we did mention earlier that the heat shield has been completely reworked.
Starship has entered the atmosphere, remains on a nominal entry trajectory.
We can start to see that plasma now starting to build up on the side. It's not quite full plasma yet, but we are starting to see that color indicate that the heat is building up on the heat shield. We then have high dynamic pressure. Starship will continue to slow down and experience increased aerodynamic loads during that phase, and that will happen before reaching Mach 1. So keep an eye on the bottom right-hand side of your screen as well. That will be the indicator when the Raptor engines ignite, if we are unable to see that illumination ourselves.
Landing burn startup.
Of that landing burn.